guess what time it is? Yes, finally. Natural hair favorites, natural hair favorites, natural hair favorites, natural hair, natural, natural. I know, I need a beat. I agree with Kayla's mom, one. I need a beat. I need a beat. But until now, until I get a beat, it's natural hair favorites, natural hair favorites, natural hair favorites, natural hair, natural, natural favorites, and some not so favorites. Yeah. Okay. Let me start out with, okay, I'm finally doing natural hair favorites for February, and I'm going to do January and February. And the reason why I didn't do a January one is because I had no favorites. None. At least none that I always, you know, if it's stuff that I already talk about all the time, like my Queen Helene shampoo, that's a given, okay? That's a given. It's a favorite. It is a staple. That's how it's, yeah, I would say it's a staple. That's how much I love that. My Kinky Curly Knot today, that's definitely a favorite. And so I don't want to keep talking about the same stuff over and over and over again, because y'all heard a year worth of that. Or pretty much a long time, several months of those two. So I was like, and then the stuff that I was trying was not favorites. So let's get started on the stuff that I use for January and February and my thoughts on it. Okay. Let's start with moisturizers. Okay. The moisturizer that I used most of January that I actually loved so much that it's finished now. And I think I might have talked about this in December and I finished it. It's totally gone. It's in my pile. Piece of hair. And it is the Soft and Free Grow Healthy Milk Protein and Olive Oil Strengthening Cream Anti-Breakage Formula. It's a moisturizer that smells like pistachio pudding. So if you like pistachio pudding, that smells so good. I wanted to eat it so many times. But anyways, I love this. It's a really good water-based moisturizer that I liked as an everyday moisturizer. Not so much after I washed my hair, but on like day 2, 3, 4, up until I was ready to wash it, this was a really good product. So just in case I didn't show you, there it is again. Okay, and then when that was done, I pulled out my Uncle Funky's Daughter Extra Butter Brilliant Shine Cream. And another hair. Good Lord, I got hair everywhere. Whew. Okay. That's what that looks like. It's a nice creamy white consistency. I don't like this after I wash my hair when my hair is wet. But on dry hair, it's fabulous. Dry hair, this is a fabulous moisturizer. Love it. Okay. A product I have talked about incessantly. I know it was probably November, definitely December, is the Tight Form Moisturizing Cream by My Honey Child. And they have a new packaging, so it doesn't look like this. But I have this one that is almost done. Has lots of hair in it too, but it's empty. Have maybe enough for maybe one more good application on my hair. I love this product. After I wash my hair, this is very good on damp hair for me. It's also good when my hair is really, really dry and I need to use it more as a kind of sealant, if that makes sense. Because this is an oil-based moisturizer. So it holds moisture longer. The other two moisturizers, the Uncle Funky's Daughter and the Soft and Free, those are water-based. So I will admit that those are products you have to use, at least I have to use, on a daily basis. This product I can use, put it on my hair one day. Let's say I put it on my hair on Tuesday. I don't need to use it again until maybe Wednesday, till Thursday. Because it just, my hair stays moisturized. And if I use it every day, my hair will become greasy. So yeah. But I love this product. Okay, now let's go to deep conditioners. That was really where I was. Okay, I think I talked about it in December, but I'm not sure, about the fact that I'm obsessed with deep conditioners right now. I have my staple deep conditioner is the Mix Silk deep conditioner. Love that. The Mix Silk curl thing. Yeah, I have tons of it. Matter of fact, Sally's did a sale. I want to say it's either February, or it might have been, I think it's the February sale, where it was like buy two something. Yeah, I got a whole bunch of those. I have like four of them now. So I love it. But anyways, I had bought a whole bunch during my Black Friday haul. I had bought a whole bunch of deep conditioner type products. And a few things afterwards in the new year also. And for example, I bought the Curl Rehab deep conditioning treatment by Curl Junkie. And everyone talks about how much they love this product. I do not like this product. It's okay. You know, it's not, it's definitely not a favorite. It's one of those products I will try to use up, but I don't love it. I don't love it. It's okay. It definitely doesn't touch my mix silk at all. At all. I still had to use a, rinse out conditioner over top of it because it gave my hair no slip. It gave my hair no, it was soft, but it wasn't that soft. I don't know what's wrong with my hair that it didn't work. It was okay. As I didn't like it as a deep conditioner. I thought it was okay as a leave-in. Because I did try it as a leave-in. Because I looked up some reviews to see. Maybe I was using it wrong. And I tried it as a leave-in. And it was okay. It was a better as a leave-in. But I have tons of moisturizers and leave-ins that I like. So this right now is sitting on my shelf. So if you have any suggestions on how to use Curl Rehab to make it more moisturizing, provide a little bit more slip, let me know. Because so far, I'm not loving this. Next up, I took advantage of the Sally sale for As I Am products. And though it's, part of me told me not to do it because I have tons of products to do. You know, I have tons of products to use. But I decided to go ahead and take advantage of the Sally sale because I really wanted this particular product, the Hydration Elation Intensive Conditioner. It's with coconut, sugarcane, green tea, apple, lemon, vegetable glycerin, shea butter, and vitamin E. Now, I thought this was going to be great. I hated the smell. First and foremost, I hated the smell. I don't know. I think it's all this stuff on it. All the coconut, sugarcane, green tea, apple, lemon, all that vegetable glycerin. I can't stand the smell. But this is the thing that got me. Now, I didn't really read the ingredients. Like, I'm just now reading that it has coconut, sugarcane, green tea, apple, lemon, vegetable glycerin, shea butter, and vitamin E. To be honest with you, I'm just now reading that. But as a deep conditioner, this was similar to me as the Curl Junkie Curl Rehab. It wasn't particularly moisturizing. It didn't leave my hair soft and fabulous like my Mix Silk deep conditioner. So I was just kind of like, okay, whatever. But what I did notice was that my head was really itching, and not itchy in that kind of irritated itchy, but itchy in that something's wrong itchy. And for the first week, I noticed it, but I didn't. I thought my hair, my scalp was just dry. So I was putting oil on it. That wasn't working. Matter of fact, I think it just irritated it more. And so I'd use it again the next week, and it continued. And I was just like, I could not figure out for the life of me what it was. Well, one day I just happened to pull it up, pull out the deep conditioner because I'm like, I'm reading it. Maybe it has something in it that I'm allergic to. I read it and I notice something called pious malice apple parentheses apple fruit extract. This has apples in it, and it has apple fruit extract in it. I am allergic to apples. And when I say I'm allergic to apples, I mean like I have an EpiPen in my purse allergic to apples. That is why this product irritated my scalp. My scalp, truthfully, I'm shocked I didn't have a bigger reaction to it. But it just felt like I was burning. It felt like my scalp was burning. That's how it itched. It itched like I was getting a relax, like I had put relaxer on my scalp. That's what it felt like. So obviously I had to stop using this. And so I will not. I've used probably half the jar. It's quite a bit I've used. But it was an okay deep conditioner, and not only was it okay, yeah, I'm allergic to it. So that's the end of that. So after I realized I'm allergic to that deep conditioner, I was like, okay, I need something else other than my Mixx Silk. And so I'm walking in. Actually, I was in CVS, and I walked over to this product, and it is the Olive Oil Replenishing Conditioner. After all that drama with those deep conditioners and wanting to find just one alternative to the Mixx Silk deep conditioner, I am wanting to find an alternative to the Mixx Silk deep conditioner. I had to think about some products that I had used previously that I liked as deep conditioners. And I wound up in CVS and I found this one, which is the Organic Root Stimulator Olive Oil Replenishing Conditioner. And this product I use throughout my transition. The whole entire time I was transitioning, this was my deep conditioner of choice. I bought this at CVS, but Sally sells an even bigger bottle. I want to say it's 16 ounces because this is 12.25 flow ounces. Absolutely love this conditioner as a deep conditioner. This is probably not as good as Silk Elements, but it's a definite backup. It's one, I think this actually does better on relaxed hair, which I think most organic root stimulator products do. I think unless they're meant for natural hair, I find organic root stimulator products actually do better on relaxed hair. And this is amazing on relaxed hair, but I do like this as a deep conditioner even on my natural hair. Now we're down to the bottom because I'm almost done. I want to make this video shorter than it is. Hopefully under 10 minutes. We'll see. Okay. Next up is the Shea Moisture Deep Treatment Mask. This is the organic raw shea butter deep treatment mask. Now, obviously, I've used this before. I use this throughout my transition, and I use it as a leave-in. And when I went natural, I stopped using it as a leave-in. And I tried to use it as a deep treatment mask. I don't know what the world for, because obviously it didn't work like everybody else. And it was Happy Nappy Kinks. And she did a video on how she used this as a leave-in slash styler. And I was like, you know, I used to use that when I was transitioning as a leave-in slash styler. So why don't I use it now? And so I did. And I love it. So this is what I use as my leave-in on dry hair. And I love it. And this is, and this, you know, is, for me, this is really good on those days when I'm not putting the type 4 moisturizing cream on my hair. So, like, let's say if I put the type 4 in my hair on Tuesday, this is a great Wednesday, and then Thursday, the type 4, and then Friday, this again, and then Saturday, it depends on how I feel, but I might not put anything in my hair Saturday. But I love this product. Oh my God. So I've been using this up and I'm so excited because now I probably won't repurchase this once I finish it, but at least I found a purpose for this so I can use it up. And then last but not least is an old favorite that I love, and this is what I've been using as my styler. And actually, the only reason I'm using this as my styler is because, well, one, I think it's definitely moisturizing, but secondly, it's just, you know, I have so many stylers I want to use, but I'm just trying to use up things in my stash. And a product that I pulled out of my stash is the Talia Wajid, or Wajid, I'm not really sure how she pronounces it, Talia Wajid Lock It Up Gel. Absolutely love this. This was definitely in my best products of 2011. And I will always use this. I like this better in the winter. And I think this is because for us, this has been a relatively mild winter. It's not as great as it was last winter when I used it, when I first started using it. I don't think my hair is as dry, especially using all these wonderfully fabulous moisturizers. But I do love this gel, and obviously I will repurchase this because this is one of my favorites, and this will always be in my stash. So love it. So those are my natural hair favorites for January and February, and my not so favorites. So I actually didn't, well, now I think about it, I only had two not so favorites. And it was the deep conditioners. Okay. That is my natural hair favorites for January and February of 2012. So until next time, talk to you later. Okay, bye.